Hi. New York One reported that city council's attendance, well, let me put it in my vulgar terms, it sucks, okay? This is a city council, New York City Council, voted themselves a raise. They kidded themselves that the budget was flush. It's never flush. And you know what? At that time, the NYPD, their starting salary was lowered. I couldn't believe it. When I found out what the community board manager was earning in the East Village where I lived, and I said, my God, this woman's earning more than a police officer that goes to work and could be killed in the line of duty. You know, here in New York City, we lost the largest amount of rescue workers in the nation's history, in the city's history, in the state's history, within each of their department, in their departments the most. Okay? It's a dangerous job. Their starting salary lowered while the city council gave themselves a raise, and their attendance sucks. If you have a job and your attendance sucks, you don't get a raise. You don't get to keep your office. You don't get to tell the people of New York, I'm deciding for you. You don't get a referendum. You don't get to vote on extending my job, my possibilities of hanging in there for a third term. You know what? These people, some of them, I'm not saying all of them, received $1 to $2 million of discretionary spending from a $20 million slush fund. So here's two things right here. Two slush funds. One is Mayor Bloomberg's and the other is called Christine Quinn's Slushgate scandal. Approximately combined, that's $40 million. We need on New York City website immediately a breakdown of that approximately $40 million. It should be on the website for the city of New York explaining everyone's name and what they got, and then a breakdown. Okay, if I got $1 to $2 million, $1 million last year and $1 million the year before of discretionary spending, I want it on the city's website. How did you spend that money? We have more and more people laid off. We have many people that don't have health insurance. We have people, they don't have teeth. They're walking around, they need new hips. They're people in need of major medical care. And they're not getting care. They're not getting, there are senior citizens, they go to Burger King. They don't have a place to sit down, or McDonald's. They have no place to go. I've asked NYU and New York Law and SBA and Cooper Union, anyone who's got a mega dorm in the East Village and anyone who's got supersized student housing in New York City, open up the front doors of your student housing and give us community outreach resource centers where people can use free computers, where an old person can come and sit down and a student can come and sit and talk with them and learn about their lives in a neighborhood where you're living, where many people were forced out so you could live there and go to college in the village, in the East Village, and tell everyone, I'm going to college, I live in the East Village. Well, you know what? You living there is a lot of the reason many people don't live there anymore. So go and help. This is a dire, dire time, and people need help. We need honesty and accountability, and we don't have it. We don't have it. It's City Hall. People didn't show up to work. They didn't show up for their job where they gave themselves a raise, where they took away our right to have a referendum to say yes or no, we want to extend term limits or we don't want it. We didn't get that. And to Mayor Bloomberg, you know what I have to say to you, Mr. Mayor Bloomberg, King Mayor Bloomberg? I welcome your philanthropy. We need it more than ever. I just don't welcome an oligarchy. I don't welcome an oligarchy or a city of multiple oligarchies, or people that want to be mini Mike Bloombergs. You know what, if I have to deal with the mini Mike Bloombergs, just give me the Mike Bloomberg. But I'm not voting for you, Mr. Bloomberg, and I'm not voting for any city council member, and many of us, I think, are gathering together. We are not voting to let you stay a third term. And how about showing up for work or just resigning, please? We need attendance records shown on the website, and we need a penalty. If you're not showing up, you have to excuse yourself, quit, or be fired. You don't get to represent people if you're not showing up. Bottom line.